गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ गोपाल ऑफ आइकन पे पब्लिक स्कूल। आई एम एन इंग्लिश टीचर। वी आर जस्ट लॉन्चिंग अ न्यू क्लास, ऑनलाइन क्लास ड्यू टू COVID-19। होप यू ऑल आर एंजॉइंग। इफ यू लाइक दिस आवर प्रोग्राम और आवर टास्क, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब इट। थैंक यू। नाउ वी विल कम टू अ टॉपिक। टुडे वी हैव गॉट अ न्यू टॉपिक, इट्स नेम इज नाउन नंबर। नाउन नंबर इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन योर लाइफ। फ्रॉम क्लास 1 to 5, 6 स्टूडेंट्स कैन गेट बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस टॉपिक। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल नो अबाउट द नंबर। नंबर हैज टू काइंड्स। नंबर हैज टू काइंड्स, सिंगुलर नंबर एंड प्लूरल नंबर्स। इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास यू हैव लर्न अबाउट जेंडर। नाउ विल लर्न अबाउट नंबर। सो इन नंबर वी नंबर एज यू ऑल नो दैट नंबर हैज टू काइंड्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सिंगुलर नंबर एंड प्लूरल नंबर। सो व्हाट इज सिंगुलर नंबर? द नंबर विच डिनोट्स वन क्रिएचर, वन थिंग, इज कॉल्ड अ सिंगुलर नंबर। एंड द नंबर विच डिनोट्स मोर देन वन क्रिएचर और थिंग, इट इज कॉल्ड प्लूरल नंबर। सपोज इफ आई राइट हियर एग, एग एग इज सिंगुलर बिकॉज वी राइट एन एग। So whenever we write n, it means that the egg is singular. That's why we are just giving n. If I write over here mango, mango. So mango is singular because we can say a mango. I have a mango. I have an egg. But in plural number we use eggs. There are too many eggs, so you write eggs. You will not mention a or n, because a or n is used with singular number. If there are no mangoes, more than one, then you will say mangoes, mangoes. So an egg shows singular number, a mango shows singular mango, eggs is denoting more than one eggs. Mangoes also denoting more mangoes. Now I will write definition of what is singular number and plural number. The number which denotes one creature or thing is said to be in singular number. The number which denotes one creature or thing is said to be in a singular number. Number two, the number which denotes more than one creature or thing is said to be in a plural number. Plural number. The number which denotes one creature or thing is said to be in a singular number. The number which denotes more than one creature or thing is said to be in a plural number. Hope you are writing these notes. This is very important notes, and you should not only write it but also remember it. so that we can help you in your class, in your home. Now, I will give some examples. Singular, plural. If I write over here, boy, boys, mango, mangoes, calf, calves, bench, benches, man, main, tooth, teeth. Now you can see there, boy, boys, mango, mangoes, calf, calves, bench, benches, man, main, tooth, teeth. So you can see that we have changed singular to plural by different rules. So but if we are just added here S, we have just added here ESS, we have added here VES, again we have added ES. Now see, vowel letter A is changed into E. Tooth, two vowel letters tooth changed into teeth. So to change into singular to plural, there are many rules. At least 6 rules are there basically to change singular into plural. Now we learn about this because simply by learning one rule, we cannot understand the whole number. So you should know, you should have idea about what are the rules, how to make singular into plural. So there are many words. So if you learn the rules, it will be very easy for you. Rule number one, first of all. We make plural generally by adding S later. Then, pens, books, doors. Now you can see that we have changed singular to plural by adding the letter S. Pen is changed into pens, book is changed into books. Door is into doors. So we basically use S letter to change singular to plural. But only by learning this only rule, we cannot make all the words singular, or we cannot change singular to plural. We have to learn more rules. This is rule number one. Now we learn about rule number two. Now see, rule number two. Each and every rule is very important. So you should go through it, learn it thoroughly. Rule number two, by
we add es to make singular into plural with the words ending with ch, sh, x, singular, plural, plural, benches. Brushes. Boxes. Buses. So you can see that we add es to make singular into plural with the words ending with ch, sh, x or s. Bench, benches, brush, brushes, box, boxes, bus, buses. Now you can see the letter ch. Ch is the whenever we use es with ch, the ch letter, we use only when it is pronounced as cha in Hindi, cha. But when it is pronounced as ka, then we will not use es. We use s. Now you can see, I'll give one example of that. We add s with ch, later when it is pronounced as ko. Stomach is changed into stomachs. Monarch is changed into monarch. So you can see that there is a ch letter at the end of this word, and we have used the letter s because it is pronounced as ka. When it is pronounced as cha, we will use es, not s. Is that clear? One thing that is very more important, that whenever we change singular plural, we have to make it known that we have to make singular plural with the words which is single countable noun. We cannot use with the uncountable noun. Suppose if I say that egg, we can count the eggs, so you can say that eggs. But when we write milk will remain same because milk is a countable noun. and A is sorry, is uncountable noun and A is countable noun. So whenever we make singular plural, we always use singular countable noun. Now we'll move to the next rule, and rule number 3. We use ES with the words ending with O. Mango. Mango is changed into mangoes. Potato. Potato is changed into potatoes. Tomato. Tomato is changed into tomatoes. So you can see that the letter is ending with O and we have added ES. But there are some exceptions which do not apply this rule. There may be O letter, and before O there should be, there may be consonant letter, but then also we use S. So we can see there are some. Good morning, friends. Myself Kapal of Icon Play Public School. I am an English teacher. We are just launching a new class, online class, due to COVID-19. Hope you all are enjoying. If you like this, our program or our task, please subscribe it. Thank you. Now, we will come to the topic. Today we have got a new topic. Its name is noun number. Noun number. It's a very important topic in your life. From class 1 to 5, 6 students can get benefit of this topic. So first of all, we'll know about the number. Number has two kinds. Number has two kinds: singular number and plural numbers. In our previous class, you have learned about gender. Now we'll learn about number. So in number, as you all know, that number has two kinds. First of all, singular number and plural number. So what is singular number? The number which denotes one creature, one thing, is called a singular number. And the number which denotes more than one creature or thing, it is called plural number. Suppose if I write here egg is singular because we write an egg. So whenever we write an, it means that the egg is singular. That's why we are just giving an. If I write over here mango, so mango is singular because we can say a mango. I have a mango, I have an egg. But in plural number we use eggs. There are too many eggs, so we write eggs. We will not mention a or an, because a or an is used with singular number. If there are more mangoes, more than one, then you will say mangoes. So an a shows singular number, a mango shows singular mango, eggs is denoting more than one eggs, mangoes also denoting more mangoes. Now I will write the definition of what is singular number and plural number. the number which denotes one creature or thing is said to be in singular number. The number which denotes one creature or thing is said to be in a singular number. Number two, the number which denotes more than one creature or thing is said to be in a plural number. The number which denotes one creature or thing is said to be in a singular number. The number which denotes more than one creature or thing is said to be in a plural number. Hope you are writing these notes. This is very important notes, and you should not only write it but also remember it, so that it can help you in your class, in your home. Now, I will give some examples. Singular, plural. If I write over here, boy, boys, mango, mangoes, calf, calves, bench, benches, man, men, tooth, teeth. Now you can see that boy, boys, mango, mangoes, calf, calves, bench, benches, man, men, tooth, teeth. So you can see that we have changed singular to plural by different rules. So we are just added here S. We have just added here ESS. We have added here VES. Again we have added ES. Now see, vowel letter A is changed into E. Tooth. Two vowel letters tooth changed into teeth. So to change into singular to plural, there are many rules. At least 6 rules are there basically to change singular into plural. Now we learn about this because simply by learning one rule we cannot understand the whole number. So you should know, you should have idea about what are the rules, how to make singular into plural. Because there are many words. So if you learn the rules, it will be very easy for you. Rule number one, first of all. We make plural generally by adding S later. Pens, books, doors. Now you can see that we have changed singular to plural by adding the letter S. Pen is changed to pens, book is changed to books, door is changed to doors. So we basically use S letter to change singular to plural. But only by learning this only rule, we cannot make all the words singular, or we cannot change singular to plural. We have to learn more rules. This is rule number one. Now we learn about rule number two. Now see, rule number two. Each and every rule is very important. So you should go through it, learn it thoroughly. Rule number two, by, we, add, ES, to make, singular into plural with the words ending with ch, sh, X, singular, plural. Benches. Brushes. Boxes. Buses. So you can see that we add ES to make singular into plural with the words ending with CH, SH, X or S. Bench, benches, brush, brushes, box, boxes, bus, buses. Now you can see the letter CH. CH is the whenever we use ES with CH, the CH letter, we use only when it is pronounced as chaw, in Hindi chaw. But when it is pronounced as ko, then we will not use ES, we have to use S. We use S. Now you can see, I'll give one example of that. We add S with CH later when it is pronounced as co stomach is changed into stomachs. Monarch is changed into monarch. So you can see that there is a CH letter at the end of this word, and we have used the letter S because it is pronounced as ch. When it is pronounced as ch, we will use ES, not S. Is that clear? One thing that is very more important, that whenever we change singular plural, we have to make it note that we have to make singular plural with the words which is singular countable noun. We cannot change, we cannot use with the uncountable noun. Suppose if I say that egg, we can count the eggs, we can say that eggs. But when we write milk, will remain same because milk is a countable noun and egg is milk is uncountable noun and egg is countable noun. So whenever we make singular plural, we always use singular countable noun. Now we'll move to the next rule, that is rule number 3. We use ES with the words ending with O. Mango is changed into mangoes. Potato is into potatoes. Tomato is changed into tomatoes. Now you can see that the letter is ending with O and we have added ES. But there are some exceptions which do not apply this rule. There may be O letter, and before O there may be consonant letter, but then also we have to use S. So we can see there are some